Martin Luther King had the hardest job ever, leading the Southern Christian Leadership Conference and, by all accounts, the civil rights movement in America. He had to fight to get massive civil rights legislation passed in Congress so that African Americans would be treated equally with whites, ending segregation in public places and banning employment discrimination on the basis of, among other things, the color of one's skin. But African Americans were in the minority, which meant that King and his coalition had to convince the minority, whites in America, that the segregation that was seen as normal in America for hundreds of years was actually wrong and an attack on human dignity. Rather than leading an army or achieving a military victory, King had to change the way millions of people thought about fundamental concepts of life. He did so in part through the brilliant use of words and language. King was a master of language, and he used it to transform people's thoughts and feelings. If you've never read Letter from a Birmingham Jail, written in August 1962, you should. It contains the famous quote, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere." King wrote it from a jail cell in Birmingham, where he had been arrested for protesting. He wrote it in response to several white pastors in town who had said King's actions in protesting were unfortunate and untimely, and that he should have waited until a more appropriate time to act. Listen to these words of King's in response to their criticism. "I guess it's easy for those who have never felt the stinging darts of segregation to say, wait. But when you have seen vicious mobs lynch your mothers and fathers at will and drown your sisters and brothers at whim, when you have seen hate-filled policemen curse, kick, brutalize, and even kill your black brothers and sisters with impunity, when you see the vast majority of your 20 million Negro brothers smothering in an airtight cage of poverty in the midst of an affluent society, when you suddenly find your tongue twisted and your speech stammering as you seek to explain to your six-year-old daughter why she cannot go to the public amusement park that has just been advertised on television and see her tears welling up in her little eyes when she is told that Funtown is closed to colored children, and see the depressing clouds of inferiority begin to form in her little mental sky, and see her begin to distort her little personality by unconsciously developing a bitterness towards white people. When you have to concoct an answer for a five-year-old son asking in agonizing pathos, 'Daddy, why do white people treat color people so mean?' then you will understand why we find it difficult to wait. There comes a time when the cup of endurance runs over and men are no longer willing to be plunged into an abyss of injustice where they experience the bleakness of corroding despair. I hope, sirs, you can understand our legitimate and unavoidable impatience." That is brilliant. I know grammar is no fun. I know writing papers can be tedious, but being able to write, to string together ideas, and to speak them in compelling ways like that is like a leadership superpower that can be used for God's kingdom in tremendous ways. God has given us this amazing gift of language, and being able to harness it well to persuade others, to move them onto God's agenda for their lives, like Dr. King did, is what leadership is all about. That's my hope for you. I love you. Have a great day.